This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and we are outside of Santa Barbara, California with Jeep. And my guest on the show is Jeff Bell, Vice President of Jeep. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Roosevelt. It's great to be here.
We're out here, obviously out in the, look like the desert, driving the new Jeep Grand Cherokee. Even though this is not supposed to be an off-road type vehicle, why are you spending so much time with the three different 4x4 systems?
Well, one of the things we like to do, Roosevelt, is ensure that if it can pass these tests of being able to go up these hills and back down and through water and over rocks, we know it's going to be safe and secure on the road. And I think you drove it a little bit today on the road, and it's a very refined ride compared to its predecessor and the competition.
Now, salespeople in the past haven't had to deal with, I guess, all the technology that you now have in these units. How are they going to be able to adequately explain to the customer so that the customer gets the right Grand Cherokee for them?
Well, one of the things that we do is spend a good bit of time focusing on training. And this fall, we're going to have a tour in 28 cities where our salespeople are going to be able to drive the new Grand Cherokee, as well as learn about the new electronic limited slip differential, the new independent front suspension, and the 3.7, 4.7, and yeah, 5.7 Hemi that's coming in the all-new Grand Cherokee.
Tell me a little bit about these 4x4 systems. I was up on the hill, down through the gully, and what makes them so unique?
Well, one of the things that Jeep prides itself on is that we hold four patents in 4x4 technology. The systems that you experience today is the QuadraTrack 1, which is a single-speed transfer case. It's an all-wheel drive all the time, but it doesn't have a low-range locker. So that's really great for those people that are going to be mostly on-road, but they like that 4x4 system in case they hit any inclement weather, snow or sleet or rain or an unexpected obstacle in the road. The QuadraTrack 2 has a low-end locker, and that's really for those people that want that additional 4x4 capability. They may be running on a two-track road if they've got a home away up north in the great state of Michigan, or maybe even down here in California or Arizona, or they like to enjoy the trails on a Jeep Jamboree or going out, whether it's fishing, camping, or hunting, and they need a little bit more capability. The ultimate for us is the QuadraDrive 2, and that's going to be featuring the electronic limited slip differential, which is front and rear lockers that are engaged automatically. Whenever there's even the slightest of slip on any one wheel, it transfers up to 2,400 foot-pound of torque to the other wheels immediately. Literally, a rotation from 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock triggers that system to transfer power to the rest of the wheels to ensure that you don't slip and slide.
Now, notice this is a complete redesign. Suspension, everything, interior. Why didn't you go to 7-passenger, 3-row seating?
Well, the reason, Roosevelt, is that we're coming next year with the Jeep Commander, and that will be a 3-row Jeep. So exactly 1 year from today, you and I will be back together again talking about the new Jeep Commander. With the Grand Cherokee, we stayed focused on 2-row, 5-passenger seating because we've sold almost 2.7 million of these since 1992. And the people that love the Grand Cherokee told us loud and clear, it's the right size. One of every five, by the way, we sell in the Northeast of the United States, a lot in New York and Boston and Philadelphia. And it's because of the maneuverability of being able to park parallel or in the parking garages, as well as go out and have fun off-road, that makes the vehicle so incredibly successful. So we've maintained the right size, we think, for this market. And then next year we'll come out with that 3-row.
Now, is this Grand Cherokee, I guess, is going back to traditional Jeep? I guess you got a little slapped in the face, maybe smacked a little bit in the press, and from some of the old Grand Cherokee drivers that you've gotten away from what Jeep is really about?
Absolutely. Whether it is with the Wrangler and the new Unlimited version, with the Liberty and now the new Renegade version, and now this all-new Grand Cherokee, we're focused up on what makes Jeep a Jeep. You know, there's a lot of choice in the marketplace, and it's important for us to be different than the competition and also desired. We believe that the type of technology that we're bringing forwards is keeping it real. This is a 4x4 first and foremost, and if that's something that you desire, you can have confidence that this is the real one.
What's the target audience for this particular unit?
This particular vehicle is going to be targeting both couples as well as families. We now have a lot of luxury amenities, including a DVD. It's got a global navigation satellite radio. It has heated front and rear seats. So it has a lot of things for the family, but we also know that there are a lot of dual income couples without children that enjoy the luxury as well as the performance of this vehicle on road and off road. So we're looking to, you know, certainly grow our sales from this year. We're looking at about 180,000 units sold this year. We'd like to grow that next year and just continue success in the future.
And I noticed in our press conference you mentioned that you reduced the price but increased the content. How'd you manage to pull that one off?
Well, as you know, we have a new COO with Tom Lasorda, who came from our manufacturing arm, and one of the reasons that we made him the chief operating officer is because he's done such an incredibly good job on both quality and on productivity. We're very, very proud of the team at Jefferson North Assembly Plant in Detroit. They have completely reworked their processes to have fewer hours per vehicle, meaning more vehicles produced per worker. We've also reduced the build combinations on this vehicle from 800,000 to about 50,000. Now, it still seems like a lot, but it basically means that we're putting more value into fewer series, and then you just choose your colors. We've been able to reduce the price by about $2,000 with content added, and a lot of that just comes from higher productivity and a good work by the UAW.
Are you going to have more options or less options on this particular unit?
I think we're going to have fewer options, but what we're going to have are value packs, what we call customer preferred option series. And so when you find the Laredo, there'll be like three really great ones to buy at $26,000, at $28,000, at $30,000. And then on the Limited, you're going to be able to start at about that $32,000, go $34,000 and $36,000. And each one of those price steps, you're going to get really high quality content with the air conditioning, the power group, the DVD, the heated seat, move up to leather, bigger wheels and tires, bigger engines. So at every step, it's very logical, and you're going to get a lot of value for the money.
Speaking of engines, why did you decide to put a Hemi in this?
Well, I guess the better question is why not? It's such a phenom, and I don't think anybody anticipated that it was going to be as big as it is. We wrestled with it, quite frankly. Even putting a Hemi into a Chrysler, we thought, is it going to work? Is it right? It was such an incredible success on the 300C, and now with the new Magnum, we knew that we could package it in the vehicle. We put it in. We love the performance, but I must stress, we tuned it differently than you'll see it in Dodge or in Chrysler. This particular version of the 5.7 V8 is 330 horsepower, which is fewer horsepower, but more torque. 375 foot-pound of torque, which makes it the most torque-oriented of all the Hemi versions, and that's because Jeep's about off-road and towing vehicles.
Tell me a little bit about the new fuel-efficient engine that you have. It goes from 8 to 4 cylinders.
Yeah, that's the multiple displacement system that is on the 5.7 Hemi. And basically, when you reach, you know, around 2,000 RPMs and you're at a steady state, it disengages on a rotating basis 4 of the 8 cylinders, which will increase your fuel economy up to 20%. So it's kind of like having your cake and eat it too. You know, you want a Hemi, you feel a little guilty, don't worry. It also has great fuel economy.
Now, you've done something very unique with the lighting. Tell me about the headlights and how those operate.
It's called the Smart Beam System, and this is something that we're really excited about. I think most people are familiar with the rain-sensitive windshield wipers, or for instance, the auto lamps that you can not worry about turning off. They'll automatically shut off. With Smart Beam, if you put that setting on, you'll be on low beam, but whenever it senses, and there's literally a camera right here in the front of the rear view mirror that's going forwards, when it senses an absence of light, it will theater up to high beam, and it will maintain that high beam to give you greater illumination until it senses oncoming traffic or any other lights that would then theater it back down to a normal beam. It just makes it so much more safe, and it's something that at first, it sounds a little strange, but once you've tried it, you're gonna absolutely love it.
Well, what is it that excites you about the new Grand Cherokee?
I think being able to know that it is absolutely the best 4x4 off-road, but an absolute dream on-road. This vehicle has rack and pinion steering, an independent front suspension, and when you get inside, it's so quiet. It honestly, the craftsmanship of the interior is like that 300, and the ride, it is so stable, so quiet, it feels again like that 300. It's just the entire new range of Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeeps are at a higher level of quality and refinement, and that's what makes this so exceptional.
Let's touch a little bit on the Liberty diesel that you have out here. Why a diesel and a Liberty?
Well, I think that the one thing that we've received a lot of feedback for many years is, can you get a diesel into a Jeep? That's something that they've been asking for because diesels have more torque. And again, when you're in the off-road environment, having that extra torque gives you traction, pulls you through, pushes you over any obstacle you might encounter. The Liberty was the one that we've done first. We're going to investigate as many as we can do, Wrangler or the Grand Cherokee, but Liberty was one that packaged very nicely with a tried and true diesel, common rail, direct injection, coming out of Europe, 2.8 liter, and it's going to have the power of a V6, but the fuel economy of an I4. And so it's really about 35% more fuel efficient than the V6 that we've got in the Liberty. So we're really excited about this vehicle. It's going to be in both the Sport and the limited versions of the Liberty coming out November production, probably market launch in January, February.
And when will the Grand Cherokee hit the dealerships?
October. It is actually being produced right now and will start shipping at the end of this month. So a few may arrive in September, but certainly nationwide in October.
Great. Thanks, Joe.
Thank you very much.
This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network. And as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time.